guys, it's Caitlin.
Because I'm 18 and I still live with my parents. Yeah, they're not like yours. Well, yours are more understanding. I've never fell in love. I save those feelings for you. So let's do all this.
And today I'm going to be doing a full face of makeup using paintbrushes. I am really, really, really scared about this challenge. I was on live on YouTube a couple hours ago and I was like, what video should I do? What videos do you guys want to see? And some girl requested that she wanted to see a full face using only paintbrushes. So I am very, very, very nervous for this challenge. This is gonna have to be our beauty blender, which I am very scared about. But if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a big old thumbs up, subscribe down below, follow all my social medias, and tune into this channel every week. And I love you guys so much. So with that being said, let's jump right into it. So I just want to say something very quickly. I have this new lamp and it's really, really pretty. You can't really see it, but there's like diamonds around it, like fake diamonds. So if that's distracting, let me know and I'll turn it off when I film, but I just want to try something different. But yeah, also I want to say I made these cute little goodie bags for Valentine's Day for my friends and they're so cute. I'm being so cute. Ah! I love it. I was digging through my craft art supplies. I used to be really obsessed with crafts, if you guys didn't know. And I found a tiny little eyeshadow brush. So that's the good thing that came out of this. That will probably be the only thing that's good about this challenge. But I am very scared, like, what am I supposed to do with this? Also, I want to say some of these brushes, like this, might look disgusting and used. I cleaned the ones that I wanted to use that were dirty. The other ones, like, I'm not gonna be using this because it's dirty and has paint on it. But some of them, most of them are clean, some of them are dirty and I just won't use them. And if I do get acne and breakout, it's because of you guys. The e.l.f. Hydrating Face Primer. And instead of squirting it on my face, we are going to do this the correct way. So I'm going to take this. This is a sponge brush. I got it wet when I wet it, so I don't know. Two pumps, okay. And I'm just gonna sponge this on my face. I'm really scared about this. I really do not want to break out. Like, I have a pimple right there. I just noticed that. But, like, I'm scared. And I used to be really into crafts. And, like, I would use this stuff all the time. So I'm scared. Now the interesting part is gonna come. I have this brush. I have a couple other like spongy brushes. I have a smaller one that I'm gonna use for concealer, but we're gonna use this for foundation. I'm actually very nervous about this, like you don't even know. But I'm gonna be using this foundation. This is the L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Makeup. I'm in the shade Classic Ivory. I'm gonna shake it, and then I'm gonna pour it onto our beauty blender. We are going to pounce it into our skin. I'm so scared. I haven't used this foundation for a hot second. Okay, we're gonna start with that much. We're gonna see how much product this absorbs. Okay, that absorbed a lot. Can you hear that noise? This feels really rough on my face, which I'm not happy about. Oh boy, that was a lot. It feels like it's absorbing a decent amount of product. So it's been a hot second. I've been massaging, or blending if you could call it that, this into my face. This is leaving streaks all over my face from the applicator. I have pores the size of craters and I never get, like, my pores aren't big, but they look like craters right now. And it's emphasizing texture a lot. I just want to show you guys close up. Like, we have creases everywhere. Pore emphasizing. This is the only concealer that I have that's like squeezy, where I could squeeze it out onto something. This is the LA Pro Girl. This has an applicator, so I can't use it like that. I'm just gonna squeeze it on there, apply underneath the eyes, and blend. This is practically the same thing that we blended in our foundation with, just smaller. And I have a feeling it's gonna be just as bad. This is taking off my foundation, not blending into the skin. Oh, what if I use a brush? I'm gonna take this brush. It's kind of wet from when I washed it. Okay, we're gonna use this. This feels so much better on my face. It is literally creating lines from the bristles, like, on my face. Like, there's actually lines. This looks so bad. Oh my goodness, you have no clue. You have no clue. Ew, I hate this. Time for powder. I'm going to be using a loose powder. I feel like this is our only option currently. This is the Coty Airspun loose face powder. I'm going to take this brush. This is just like a fluffy brush, and I feel like I could swoop this under my, yeah. It's actually soft too. Oh yeah. Bro, I might add this to my makeup collection. That's so soft. Oh my goodness, that's the softest thing I've ever put on my face. Oh, there is powder everywhere. Okay, I'm gonna set the rest of my face, kind of just doing like swirling motions with the powder on the brush. So now it's time for bronzer and contour. I didn't show you guys this, I just got it. This is the Kat Von D Shade and Light Contour Palette. I am so excited about this. I just bought it and look how gorgeous. I've only used it one time. But I have no clue what brush I could use for contouring. Like no clue. This is like the only one that's kind of sticking out to me. Ooh, that's hard. What do you use for contour? Like there's nothing in, whatever. We're just gonna go with it. Okay, we are going to contour with this. And with this, and I'm going to take this shade right here. It's like a cool, oh no, look at the powder. I can't use that, no. Look at this. You're kidding. Okay, I cannot dip this back into this powder. It's gonna ruin it, and I just got it. So now that we look like a bronze goddess, I'm gonna sweep this powder off of our face using our favorite brush. I should have contoured with this. I'm so dumb. That's what we look like. Slay queen. We are now going to apply some blush. I'm going to use our favorite foundation brush. This is cream blush, by the way, so I shouldn't have put on that much powder. Whatever. Okay, I'm gonna take this pink one right here. I have not used this shade yet, and I'm really excited. And like, I feel like this brush might kind of work for blush. Because like, you stamp it, and then you like, I feel like, oh, that's pretty. Tell me why I like it for blush. I think because you stamp it and just pat it and it's, oh, that's cute. Oh, I like this. Oh, it's shedding into my palette. Can you see that? There's hairs on my palette from this brush. Ew, I need to get those out. I am not gonna risk my Anastasia Glow Kit because this is my favorite thing and I'm not gonna use a paintbrush in it because that would break my heart. So we're gonna use my e.l.f. highlighter. This is my favorite drugstore highlighter by far. It is so freaking good. And I am going to use, I'm going to use this brush. This brush is calling me. I don't know. I think we could get a cute little nose highlight with it. As always, we're gonna spritz our brush, even if we are using paintbrushes. We spritz the brush. I'm gonna take my Mari Badescu. Does that count? Like, is this cheating? Whatever. It's okay. It's okay. And we're going to take our e.l.f. This is the baked highlighter in the shade Moonlight Pearls. Oh no, it scratched it. It's okay. This is like $3 or something. And we're going to highlight the nose. Ooh, girl. Hey, we got a pinched nose. Now we're time for brows. And I'm genuinely nervous about this. There are not very many angled brushes in here. And that's what we need to create a brow. These are all like fluffy brows. Oh, this might work. Will this work? We are gonna have to use this. Okay. My Milani Stay Put All Day Brow Pomade. My e.l.f. one is too dark and I feel like that would really ruin this look. What are you doing up there? A spoolie to use. We don't have anything to use. What if this becomes my new favorite brow brush? This is genuinely a struggle. There's no angled brushes in this paintbrush set. Excuse me. This is the best our brows are gonna be. Genuinely not as hard as I thought it was gonna be. Like, it's not easy to do it, and that move to like, my brows do not look good, but like, they don't look bad. Like, the bronzer and like the foundation application is way worse than that. Like, I'm not mad. Take my ABH palette. And I'm going to take this fluffy brush, and honestly, this could be an eyeshadow brush, just saying. Oh, that's a bit hard. Whatever, we're gonna make it work. So we're gonna get a little up close and personal. I never get this up close and personal with y'all, and we're gonna do it today. Screaming my name, okay. We need to start with the fluffy ones. So I'm going to take burnt orange right here, just an orangey shade on this fluffy brush. And we're gonna try and build up some color. This Anastasia palette is so pigmented. Next, we're gonna go back to that other brush, and I'm gonna take Realgar, I think is how you say it. And apply that right under the crease. We're gonna go for like a sunset look, you know? I saw a YouTuber do a sunset makeup tutorial recently, and I'm inspired. And I wanna bring this down to the lower lash line. Okay, this is scary, but it's okay. It's okay, I'm okay. Brush actually looks good. And I'm gonna take Cypress Umber right here, a brown. And this brush picked up so much product, I'm actually excited for it. Ooh. I kinda wanna do a smoky liner. Okay, I'm gonna do that. Still trying to do the smoky liner. I thought this brush was gonna be better, it's not. But we're gonna make it work. We're balling on a budget. Do you think paintbrushes are cheaper than makeup brushes? Probably, depending on what makeup brushes you get. Ooh, girl. Okay, this eyeshadow is actually being a struggle for me. It's like not easy. Lips. I'm genuinely scared for lips. But like there's some good brushes that I feel like could work, you know? Okay, we're gonna try to apply a matte liquid lipstick. I'm gonna do red, because this is supposed to be sunset. So normally you would go in with this. By the way, this is the ColourPop liquid lipstick, by the way, BT dubs. And instead, what brush should we use? We're gonna use this brush, this is small. So I'm just gonna grab the product. This might be a success. I'm really not good at lips. Oh no. Spoke too soon. This is all I am capable of doing currently. I do not want to see myself fail any more than I already have. I thought that I was gonna kill this challenge, but genuinely very, very hard. The bronzer, the lipstick, the eyeshadow, and the brows are probably the worst part. The face looks actually kind of good, like the makeup all blended in well together. This kind of hurts when you apply it, but other than that, like, I'm definitely adding this brush to my everyday makeup collection. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a big old thumbs up, subscribe down below, follow all my social medias, and tune in my channel weekly, because I love you guys. Thank you guys so much for 4,000 subscribers. I love you, and have a great day.